Hi everyone, welcome back to Ski Regional Simulator. Here we are. Don't adjust your sets, it is just becoming overcast. You can see the clouds are rolling in over the mountain. We are expecting snow... Oh! And as I speak, snowfall. Yes, so we've got to keep an eye on our condition of our slopes. Because as you can see, snow level is good, but the grooming condition is slowly starting to lessen. We have a quick look at our slopes. We've got three at the moment, and the bottom graph, which is the grooming graph, you can see they're not optimal, but they're still pretty good. They're still not anything to worry about, but we need to keep an eye on those. With the more snowfall expected today, we will... Oh yeah, it looks really coming down. You see the not just the snowflakes, but the blustery bits coming through as well. We might have some drifting snow, which would be quite exciting. The helicopters are coming into land. Obviously, they don't want to be out in tough weather conditions. And I'll give you a little update on what's going on. As you can see, we have $157,000 in the bank. And if I... No, I need to go to the cash point, isn't it? I always press the insert key thinking this is Farm Simulator. Right. So, yeah, we made a loss of 42 grand yesterday, but we did, of course, purchase the construction of 350,000 to only be... Let me start again. We've made a loss of 42,000 in negative. That's where we are currently. Oh, I'll get out in a minute. Yesterday, we made a loss of 236,000, which is okay because we had 350,000. So we made 100 grand yesterday, which is what I'm trying to say. So money wise, we're doing okay. We'll do a quick check on our playgroup or our childcare service. He brought in 4 grand yesterday, which is fantastic. And it's already brought 360 grand in. And it only costing us 600 grand, £600 a day or dollars a day, which is great. So we've got that down here. Here we go. Up at the top of the slope, slope 8, we have our ski school, which is currently maxed out at the moment. Ooh. Okay. Can we make a bigger ski school? What's that? As a ski rental? No, we can't. Oh, that's a shame. I'd like to upgrade it, you know, to like a bigger one, but it seems that's not the option. Anyway, so good news is it's been fully utilised and it brought in 4.5 grand yesterday. So £4,000 profit yesterday on that thingy alone. The drugstore, which has been our top earner, 5 grand yesterday. So that brought in 4.5 grand yesterday as well. That's doing okay. It's at 90% capacity, which is okay. Potentially that means, of course, that we could get another ski school going. The food stall is at 78% usage. It's bringing in just under 3 grand. Only costs us 150 a day. That is doing great. And this ski lift, day ticket price is $46, which is the recommended price. Maxed out yesterday. 574 tickets sold at $46. That is quite a tidy profit. Cool. So, I've got this up here because obviously this is where the slopes meet. So we're here currently. So we've got our slope there, and our red slope here. Now I finished grooming slope 4 at the end of the previous episode, but with the snowfall already, you can see the conditioning has dropped a little. But we would like to get some more snowfall to cover up these little scrappy stony patches or whatever they are. So yeah, that is okay. Cool. What we could do is skip over to here. Oh, props for a shallow dwarf blick. A group of actors forgot their props in the village. 8 grand. Sure, we'll do it. We're still very much trying to earn as much money as we can. So we'll just switch the delivery to the delivery tray. Or sleds. Oh my goodness, I can't get my words out today. That's the problem when you record it on a Sunday morning when you're tired. Well, not tired, just, yeah. I had a bit of a lay-in this morning and then the brain hasn't quite woken up with the rest of the body. She's good. It's Sunday. Right. Where is Blixdorf? It's miles up the middle. Okay, fine. We need to keep an eye on our car park, of course. We'll come back and check this station and the car park to see what status they're at. But one of the things we were going to buy was the little digger. The little skidster digger, if you remember. And with that, we were going to be able to fill up the salt bucket on the back of the tractor. But we've also got enough money to maybe do one of the upgrades at our big, expensive station halfway up the hill. Now, thank you ever so much for all your comments regarding gnome spotting. Apparently there's one. Yes, there is. There's one just there. Look at that. We are on the timer, but... Oh, come on. Oh, really? Come on. Oh, we'll have to come back for it. The timer's going. But thank you for pointing that one out. There was also actually another one. Because people... thank you for the comments. Did say they were on the that bridge. But I actually found another one. Actually on top of the bridge, on the railings, and that's what the one I thought it was, until I checked the comments just before recording this video again. They said no, look at this timestamp on the video and you'll see him on the left. And I thought, oh yeah, there he is. Fantastic. So thank you ever so much for that. So if you see a gnome during the video, please give a timestamp and where he is on that screen so I can come back and nab them. Oh, that's not gone well. I have, let's have a look, 51 gnomes found already, which, it doesn't, it's only halfway there, but believe me, that is quite the achievement. It is quite difficult to find them all. I'm sure if I was to put it into, Giants Editor, if this will actually work with Giants Editor, I've not thought about that, actually, but it probably would, then I could probably just find them and do it that way, but that's not the point, is it? You know, you've got to do it properly. You've got to go through the mind-numbing pain of trying to find these damn things to actually get that sense of achievement once you get them. Right. Let us see if... I'll close that for a second. See, he's camouflaged. You can't see him there, can you? Come on, you bugger. Yes! Got him. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much. Ah! Wow, look at the snow on these slopes now. It's really thickening up, isn't it? Wow. This is a proper snowfall. Now, I'm no skier, but I should imagine this is quite good fun to begin with. All that loose snow. But I should imagine that's probably quite a dangerous thing. Because otherwise, you wouldn't groom the snow, would you? But I should imagine when it first starts falling, it's quite good fun kicking up all that snow. Right, we'll just come back here and check on the station. It's got really dark, isn't it? It's only 9:20 in the morning. It's really dark. Okay, so we've got 172 grand now, which is good. So our little kiosk here brought in, wowza, $7,890 yesterday. And it's only 91%. Oh, that was last hour, actually. It's not fully utilised yet, which is great. Look, it's 9:20 in the morning. It costs us $190 a day, and we've already earned 1,200. Blimey. That is a super little store. Right, our kiosk booth, or info booth, sorry, already paid for itself, and $42 in profit already. Brought in $2,300 yesterday. And of course, it gives us the option to have a look at the what people are requesting, such as a dance club, a Euro dance, or romance. sun deck, hotel type, luxurious, party, food stall, caviar, salad. Why would you want a salad up here? You want something warm and filling and yummy. A kiosk, got that, and an info booth, got that. They want a spa. Okay. So there's definitely, I think we're definitely going to have to remodel up yonder, or up over there somewhere, for the more upmarket clientele. The other half, as they say. This is doing great. This is $46 for the Hoja Station lift. 574 tickets sold yesterday, precise. In the last hour, it's 82% used. Okay. quick check on the car park, because that looks like it's covered in snow. Its parking lot is 50%. Oh my goodness, we need to get that sorted. Oh, look at this, and our grooming has completely gone with this snow. Oh my goodness, this was thick snow. Okay, well, we might as well at least groom a little bit as we go down the hill. That sounds a bit weird, doesn't it? But actually, we'll come back and do eight, but oh my goodness. I didn't think this was going to be that heavy a snowfall. Now, it'd be worth experimenting. I'm sure those of you who played this game already know. If... If we do this now while it's still snowing, will this cover over again? I'm guessing it will, which means do we wait until the snowfall is gone and over, finished, finito. We don't have to worry about it. Yeah, but look at that parking lot, it's covered in snow. I have to keep that one open. Oh, this is it, things are happening now. Oh, finally. So yes, we can also go and buy that skidster tractor, or a little skidster digger thing, so we can get some salt loaded up into the salt sprayer, and we get that salted as well. Brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. That is why we've made these investments. That is it. We are doing well now. Right. I can't actually see the end of the ski, so I think it's about there. Right, well, abandon that for a second. We'll bring on the snow plow. So, can I angle that snow plow at all? Yes, I can. Angle it the other way. Brilliant. Obviously, we want to push it off onto the side rather than. Yeah, it's working! It's working! Okay, we really need to look where we're going though. That's not going well. We might need to get this thing off, the groomer off the back of the truck as well. Nice! We can come back, should we? So we'll have to spin that to point the other way. It's kind of like ploughing this, isn't it? But it is snow ploughing. Yeah, sorry. Okay. It's a bit of a dip, so I'm going to go for it, and I'm going to lower that a little bit lower than it normally would. Not gone well. Actually, I'm thinking what am I doing? I'm probably doing that the wrong way, aren't I? I need to push that. So I'm not going to push it back onto what I've just done. I like this snow mechanic. It's cool. I am just going to drop the groomer actually because it's wiggling around and it'll catch on stuff. It's slightly irritating me. So we'll just drop that over here. There we go. We can go full piston bully rescue team. I need to get that ski thingy out of the way as well. The Sherpa out of the way. Let's quickly get this, put all the things in the way. But this just creates a lot more work for us, which is great, because you know that we were struggling a little bit for work. But this is it, this is what we're here for. The main cut and thrust of the ski business. Right. Okay, hang on, that's a little bit. There you go, sorry. That was a little bit too far down, and it was actually taking all steering off. Oh, bugger. We waited too long. Right, okay. Let's get going again then. Let's just... Oh, no! problem is, if you're not on perfectly straight ground, the plough just digs in and you've got no steering control whatsoever. Right, let's just blitz this as quick as we can. Right, push that out of the way. Beautiful. Now we probably want to... move it like that. Again, I think we probably... this is going to be a bit futile, because the time we do this, it's just going to cover up in snow again, isn't it? Again! No steering! Get up! Ugh, this is frustrating, actually. There you go. This must be the equivalent of doing the front loader on the tractor. The problem is... of course, the ground around where you want to work is not level. So that means it just digs in all the time. I just want to quickly check something. Are we actually... is that classed as the condition is 1%? I don't think that's actually the parking lot. I think the parking lot is actually inside that. I think I'm just doing the road for no apparent reason. So let's just see if we can get this bit done. Stick our hazards on, or our doobie-doos on. Yeah, because that's technically the road. There's an accident. Can't you see I'm busy cleaning my car park? There are some more pressing matters. If we don't get the car park clean, then we're not going to be earning money. People aren't going to be coming in. Why is that going that way? Okay. I guess it's while it's snowing, you can't really be perfect. It's just a case of trying to get something open. So we were basically working on a piece of road which wasn't ours. Which is a bit frustrating. But these are all good learning lessons. Can we get that a little bit more angled? There we go. So we should clean that up again. We'll have to go over that again. Well, it's slow going. I'll give it, you know, I'll say that much. But we are slowly getting there now. Clear a bit of the road for them as well, because, you know, I'm a good guy. We want them to, you know, there's no point to have a beautifully clean car park if they can't actually get to the car park. Right, we're getting there. Now most car parks will probably just do this, and then the parking spaces will be... oh my god, look how thick this snow is! It's going to take several swipes across this to get this done. Wow. We're getting there though. We're getting there slowly. Start to see the car park taking shape again. Goodness me. I am starting to think this is a futile effort because the snow is just covering it up again. But it's all good practice for what, when, you know. Let's get this back up and operational. Wow. When it snows, it really does snow. Get that bit again. Going over old ground a touch, but it's okay. I'm guessing that first bit of the blade I shouldn't use because that still allows snow to get pushed in. So I should really have a huge overlap. I'm guessing, so like that, and then we should keep it clear. Yeah, that kind of works. It's getting used to these things. Ah! Took about a lesson in futility. Okay, let's come over here, and then we're gonna go and let's go and buy that little thingy. This skidster. Here we go. It was this one, wasn't it? Well, that's a loader with shield. That's a loader with bucket. We want the bucket one, please. Okay. Fetch our purchase at the store. Here it is. Oh, isn't she gorgeous? Brilliant. Does she have a... She doesn't have a... She doesn't have a flashing light on, but she has lights. Because yeah, what we'd obviously need to do is grit at the same time, which is a bit of a faff. So the answers to the questions have been provided. There is no point trying to do this and keep up with the snow. We've just got to wait for the snow to finish, then tidy up. Right, so we'll get this all ready for works. Let's lower that down as well. And pull out a bit. Happening. I can't say anything. Oh, there we go. Brilliant. Okay, job done. This is out of an experiment. We'll just chuck this grit on the snow and see if anything happens. No. I guess once the snow's already formed, you know, true to life, you just chuck grit on snow, not much happens. Right, so let's cover that up. Lift that up. And we'll drive to our car park in our chained up tractor. That's brilliant. Yeah, and I guess we can't do much at the moment until the snow slows down a little bit. Obviously this is gonna cut into our profits a wee bit. Okay, here we go. Come on, let's just finish this off then. We are almost there. Done mind-numbing the amount of work with this. It's not perfect, sure, it's not perfect, but it's... In this situation, it's going to be good enough. Good enough for me, and I'm going to sign this one off. So I'm just going to tidy this up, and we are going to do a bit of graveling. Do a bit of... gritting on this surface. Hopefully that'll get rid of all the ice. We've done... Oh! That is 90% of the work done. So, let's get us going. I've done a bit of gritting already. I'll just finish off gritting the bits we haven't done. Just like fertilizing. And you can get rid of all this low-level snow, which is quite good. We'll come around here. Let's get rid of some of it. Not all of it, but that's okay. Now that road's not technically ours, but we could maybe clear that when we've got some time. Bit of leisure, but we've got some slopes to groom as well, so look how, just seriously, look how thick that snow is. Incredible. And actually, is the grit just melting everything? If that's the case, I think the next time we don't have to worry about the snow plow, we'll just grit everything. You know it does. It just... Well, that... anyway, you've learned a lesson. We'll know for next time. Right, so we'll get this bit done. Lovely. Look at this. See the parking lot again. While I've been doing this, I've been constantly badgered to hire helpers to groom the slopes and stuff. It's like, nope. We're doing that ourselves. I'm not paying good money out for that, which we can do. Right, I think that car park is almost done. We'll just tidy up some of these little bits. Whoops. Drive straight into a lamppost for the thrill of it. There we go. And I think we'll call this one completed. Yes! One cleared car park. How's about that then? Hey, hey? What do they reckon? What kind of condition have they given it? 99%. That'll do. That'll do. We'll come and tidy up that one remaining 1%. Chances are... Oh no, the sun's come out. Look. You can see by the indicator in the top. Right. We'll take you... Well, we'll park you there for a second actually, because we might need to use you to clear the road. Where's my piston bully? Here you are. So, we've got some slopes to groom. Now that our car park is back in order. So, I will probably... Oh, I don't know actually. Should I... I'll probably leave it there. And we'll probably pick up the grooming next time. I'll probably just drive up with the groomer to get this one working. Wow, look at the snow. Look at the snow on here. Which is good, because, you know, the snow levels were beginning to drop a little bit, so it's great that we've had a heavy snowfall. Wow. Yeah, even the plough is actually digging into the snow as we're coming up here. I'm struggling to go in a straight line, actually. Can I lift the plough a little bit more? No, that makes no difference at all. Yeah, that was just really, really heavy snow. Okay, so I'll leave it there, guys. It's been a bit of a frustrating episode for me, anyway. That snow ploughing is not the most enjoyable activities, and I think next time, if we get the option for somebody else to do it, we will definitely pay them to do that, because my God, that wasn't fun. That was hard work. So this goes all the way up to our ski slope up there, but I'm going to try and at least get one ski slope open. See, that snowplow is being a pain in the backside, isn't it? It's actually pushing snow on what we've just done. So I'm going to drop that off when we get down to the bottom of the hill, because that is just causing more work for ourselves. Okay, but already this is looking much better. Okay, so what I'll probably do, I'll probably groom this slope offline. I'll probably groom the big slope as well offline, and then when we come back next time, we'll start by grooming the... Slope 8, which is the one we started with all that time ago. And we'll also then have a look at the hotel, because we've got the hotel which we have been managing badly. We've got it set for kids and families, and it hasn't been that profitable, but we'll see if that's changed in the last few days, because I haven't really kept an eye on it, to be honest. So that's okay. And we've got some money, we've got 100 grand, which we can potentially go and spend on upgrading our fancy station up the top of the mountain, which would be grand. Drop the snowplow there. Nope. The snowplow I wanted to drop, please. Thank you. All these people in the way. Get out of the way! Can you see I'm not trying to... I'm trying to make this safer for you. Keep skiing into me. That's not safer for you. Right. I might go and groom the roads. That'd be quite interesting. See if I get any bonuses for that. Okay, guys. I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. I'm not paying 13 grand for the slope to be groomed. No. Grooming is easy. It's a bit monotonous, sure, but it's easy. Anyway, I'll leave it there, guys. Thanks for watching. As I say, next time we'll come back and do the upgrades. So, thoughts on upgrades. I think the upmarket clientele is what we'll probably go for. That's what most of you seem to be favouring as well. With a nightclub. Nightclub has been in constant demand now by the peeps. So we'll go for maybe a nightclub. And if we've got the money, potentially a helicopter pad up there as well. That'd be quite good. Or a spa and a conference room. I think they were the big ones, what people kept asking for. So we'll have a look at what the prices are like for those. And we'll go from there. So, thanks for watching, guys. I'll crack on with this work and catch me next time in Ski Regional Simulator. So I'll see you then.